In the last video, we have seen how to create a new project using the command line tool. But in this video, we are going to see and analyze the files and folders that are created when we create a new project of Flutter. So here on my screen, you can see that in the left, we have some files and folders. So I'm going to tell you about these files one by one so that you have some better idea that why these files are here and what is the purpose of these files. So let me zoom in. So first of all, you can just expand the folder and see there are some files. First of all, there is dartool. We can just ignore these two folders, .id and .dartool. And third number is the Android folder. And for the third number, this is our Android native project. Since Flutter uses the native languages and native projects, so Flutter has created a native Android project in it. And here you can see all the native Android project related files in the Android folder. We can just, you know, collapse it. And on the fourth number, we can see there is an iOS folder which contains all the Xcode project related files or the iOS project related files. These can be opened directly in the Xcode. And this folder can be directly opened into the Android Studio or as an Android project. And on the fifth number, we have the lib folder. This is our main folder that will contain all the code related to Flutter project, and we will utilize it and use it in our Flutter project. So right now, you can see on the right hand side, we have that file opened. And in upcoming videos, I will explain you how this code is working and how to, you know, manipulate it. And next we have the test folder. Here our testing related code will reside if we want to do testing. And since I have enabled the web support for my Flutter products, here you can see I have the web folder as well. If you have not enabled the web support, then you won't be able to see this folder. So next is gitignore. This is something related to Git and project management. So I can, you know, right now ignore it. And next we have the metadata and packages information. Let me zoom out and zoom in again a little bit. Here you can see there is some pubspec.yaml file. We will be focusing on two files majorly in this, you know, project. First is the main.dart file, and second is the pubspec.yaml file. These are the files that we are gonna use for Flutter apps development on a regular basis. And next we have the readme file. Readme file is something that, you know, we can use to create a readme for our Git project, so that it can, you know, be self-explanatory. But again, you can ignore this file as well. And just focus on the main.dart file and pubspec.yaml file for now. And later on, we will, you know, try to understand why these Android and iOS related projects are there and which files are needed to be used in these folders and how we can utilize them. So just ignore everything and just focus on the lib folder and the pubspec.yaml file for now. And later on, you will realize that why these other files are here, but you don't have to worry about them for now. So in the next video, we will see how to create a new virtual device on Windows and try to run our first project. See you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.